Hello, Klaus here, and here's a quick look at DaVinci Resolve on the iPad. This video is made specific if you are new to DaVinci Resolve, and especially if you are new to DaVinci Resolve on the iPad. So DaVinci Resolve is a full-fledged version that can edit and color grade your footage in a insane quality. You have so many great features here. And by the way, I am using the free version right now, so there is some things you can't do, but we can always talk about that later. First off, DaVinci Resolve is divided into pages. It's the cut page, and if we click here, we have the color page. And the color page is very much known from what DaVinci Resolve is known for color grading. But we'll go into that later. So first off, let's just take a quick look here at the cut page. So in the cut page, we have our timeline right here. We have our viewer here and our media pool right here. And if we want to add in some media, we can simply just double tap import media. I'll go to my folder here where I have all my footage. By the way, I am using a hard drive with all my footage here, so it's a little bit easier. I'm going to take or import some of these clips in here like that. And I'm going to open these. Want to change the frame rate? Don't change. So here we have the clips in here, and you know, we can just, let's highlight a clip, and we can then scrub through here, or we can push the playhead here and see the clip we have right here, which is kind of cool. So if we want to add a clip into our timeline, we're simply just going to push right here and drag. And here we have the clip down inside of the timeline, and now we can see our timeline here like that. So if you're wondering what, you have two timelines, what that is. So basically this is a zoomed down version of the entire timeline. So as you see, they will move the same, doesn't matter. And you can kind of see how they move. So that's just why you have two of those. So let's say you want to do a cut. There's a couple of ways you can do a cut into this. It would be either to go over here and push this cut icon here, and now we have done a cut, or push and hold for a sec. And here we can use the split, and we're going to split the clip. So now we have done that, and let's say we want to remove the middle clip here. We're going to select that, and we're just going to push the trash can over here. So now we have a little edit already here. We can just run that through like that. If you want to make it run in loop, we're just going to push this icon right here, and we can push play, and it will then run our edit into the loop like that. Also, we have some other options of trimming stuff. If we want to, we can go here and we can trim stuff by dragging. And then we can see we are now taking this clip here and pushing it this way. Or we can do it the other way. So now we have some clips. Maybe we want to add in another clip. Let's do that. Let's take this train over here. I'm going to double tap that. So again, there's a couple of ways of adding this clip in. We could just do as we did before, like take and drag, and we have it in. Also, we could go and let's say we want to take a portion of the clip instead. Let's say we go, I want to use this clip here. We can then put an in and an out point. And we do that by using these two icons over here. So I'm going to push this to do an in point. And we're then going to go a little forward, and I'm going to put a out point right here. So now if we drag, we only take this portion of the clip, or we could use some of the buttons we have here. This is like smart insert. The way smart insert works is like it will go to the closest edit point. So you see this arrow right here. If I go a little forward here, now we have the arrow right here. So this is where the closest edit is. So if I push the smart insert right here, it's going to put it at the end. Okay, I just want to redo that. Also, we could use the append to end, which is right here. If we push this, doesn't matter where we are in our timeline, it's going to put it to the end of our clip. Now we have a sort of an edit here. So now we can see we have a edit, which is kind of cool. an edit about toys and stuff like that. So obviously you would make something a little more interesting when doing an edit, but however, let's just go further in this tutorial. Let's go and add in a transition, because we have a bunch of those. I'm going to add in a transition up here between the two clips. If we go up here, we have our transitions, and I'm just going to push this, and then we have a selection of different things we can add. Let's say we want to add in heart shape. Why not? Because we can. I'm going to take my heart here and push this into my clip. So it's going to be right here. And so now I have this lovely transition for the next scene. However, we can actually change things around as well. So if we highlight the transition itself, we're going to click here, we'll go up to our inspector. And in our inspector, we can, of course, change the aspect ratio and stuff like that, or borders. We can add in a border to our heart here. We can go in and change the rotation and the aspect ratio. We can offset the corners. We can change the color. Let's say we want to do something like that. Okay, we'll go there. So we have this red. I'm going to red border of the heart. And in fact, we could also do stuff like, let's say we go to the beginning here and we have this border. So I'm going to push this icon, which is a keyframe. And then we're just going to go forward here. So when it's here, I want my border to be bigger, something like that. And then it will go towards here. And when it's here, I want my border to be small again, something like that. So now we've done a super crazy small little animation with that. There we go. So stuff like that you can do in the inspector if you are using a transition. Talking about things you can do in the inspector, if we select a clip and we go into this icon here, we can actually also take our image and we can zoom it, change the position, something like that. And we can, of course, keyframe everything by using these diamond icons right here, which is kind of helpful if you want to do something in particularly. And if you want to reset anything you do, you can just push this icon up here. It's going to reset all of the things you messed around with and going back to normal. So now we have a little movie here, and let's add in a title. So if we go up here, we have titles. We have a bunch of different titles. Let's just take a super simple one. Let's take this sensor reveal. We have that right here. I'm just going to push this here, and then we can click here and go into the inspector. And in here, we can change the text. We can change the font and colors and all of that stuff. You can play around with that. So now we have a little clip here with a title coming in. Pretty neat. It runs very well, by the way, on this system here. So I'm just going to push down the inspector for a second. Other things you can do as well is, for instance, if you are grading and stuff like that, or you have different clips you want. Another thing I am using all of the time is if we take a clip and push, we're going to get this menu up and we can actually change the clip color into something completely else. Let's say we want to change it into purple, whatever. The main reason for doing something like that is to be a little bit more organized when you are working. Again, just a little thing nice to know how to do, actually. Another thing you might want to know as well is that if you look at the clips are actually a combined audio and video together, so they don't have like a different track or anything like that. So it is audio and video in the same clip. And if there is any audio, you will see them down here. In my case, there is no audio here whatsoever, so that's why you can't see the audio waveforms down in the bottom here. Also, we have a bunch of effects. So if you want to, I don't know, put some kind of overlay or night vision or a video camera or something like that on, we can put that on this clip here. So now we have this effect here. And of course, if we select the clip, go into the inspector and go into the effects, which is this here, we can actually go in and change, for instance, the battery level here. So it's not so much, and that's actually, it's running out of battery. So it's almost dying on us here. And then we can change stuff around again. Cool thing, it's right there. And we can, of course, also do an animation with the rec light up here. If we want to do that, we can just put in a keyframe and then do the animation like that. So pretty cool. And if you want to add in some music or something like that, into that, we are going to go back to the media pool here. And I'm going to hold down my pen here, and I'm going to import new media. And again, I'll go into my storage device, go into the iPad, and I have here a music track, and I'm going to open that. I'm going to put that in, and now I can do the same thing as with video, you know, play around with the audio, do in points and out points, and then I can just drag it and put it down here. And now it's going to be underneath the video, and this is a audio track now, and we can control that as we want. If we want to turn down the volume, we're simply going to select the clip, go up to the inspector, and go into the audio tab, and here we can just push down the volume, and we can see right here it's going to show us exactly what we are doing. So maybe we'll do something like that, push down the inspector, and then, you know, cut down the video or the sound here just by pushing the cut here, selecting the rest of our audio, and put it into the trash can. So now we have our beautiful movie here. So let's just jump into the color tab. And when you take a look at the color tab, I know this is kind of daunting. There's so many buttons, and what do they all do? But if you are new to DaVinci Resolve, don't worry about all of this yet. The most important thing would be just to know the primary color wheels. And that's exactly what I'll just show you right now. So first off, we have, this is our timeline. So the clip we want to work on is the clip we're going to select, this clip here. So here we have the primary color wheels. This consists of four color wheels, the lift, gamma, gain, and offset. The offset we can take here, and we can drag the colors around. The further we throw it away out here, the more saturated it's going to be. Not necessarily what we want. So if we did something that looks totally terrible, we can just click right here, and it's going to reset that. So whenever we are messing around with this, we are actually controlling the colors of the entire image. And maybe that is not what we want. So that's why we have the lift, gamma, and gain. So the lift is actually, let's just go a little in here. The lift is actually the colors in the darkest area. So if you want to turn this a little more bluish, we can go in here and drag this towards blue. It's only going to affect the darkest part of the image. If we go to the gain, it's the lightest parts of the image that we can push towards colors. And the gamma is the midtones. So everything in between the darkest point and the lightest point of your image. You can do something like that. Cool. And if we did something that messed everything up, we can just push right here, and it's going to redo everything. Okay, there's some other kind of small little thing you can adjust as well. Down here underneath all of our color wheels, we have the master. And that is going to push either the colors towards the dark. In this case, this is the shadows. So we're going to push this really much. Something like that. And again, this is going to do this with the light. And here we are playing around with the mids. Then we also have some different other controls as well. Down here we have, for instance, saturation. So we're going to saturate our image or desaturate, depending on what we want. We also have a hue, so we can change around the hues, something like that. If we want to reset anything we did, we can also just double tap here on the name of the thing we used. Also, we have a color boost. This is just going to boost certain colors, and this can be pretty aggressive, so I'm not using that too often. Up here, we have the contrast. So we can kind of make our image look more contrasty. And the pivot and the contrast is kind of helping each other here, so you can redo some of the stuff you did. Then we also have a tint and the temperature. If we want to make our image warmer or, you know, cooler, we can do that right here. So this is super basic of what you can do with DaVinci Resolve 18 on the iPad. So if you're interested in learning something specific, please do write it down in the comments below and I'll come back with some more videos. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.